Everyone, happy Monday, everyone. How was your weekend? Hope everyone enjoyed their weekend, get something fun done, and also get some work done if you did any work over your weekend. So just let me know how your weekend went. Hi, Lloyd. Let me silence my phone here. So I'm going to be talking about credit score. Now that you're in business, you're making a lot of money. What's up, Melise? How are you? Now that you're in business and you want to make sure that you're improving your credit score. So whether you have a lower score or you feel like you have a high score, I think this information is really important because sometimes we may believe certain things about our credit. I know that I've learned a lot. I've learned a lot of information even about my credit score and some of the things that I thought would increase my credit score over other items. So even if you have a pretty good credit score, in your mind, then this information still can help you to increase your credit score or to even get utilize your credit more. To get a better utilization of your credit score now that you're in business, now that you're growing your business, so it may be opportunity when you're going to be able to not only use your credit score, get better rates based on your credit score, and also as you start hiring employees or contractors and start generating more cash flow, then your credit score is gonna become way more important. I know a lot of people want to ask about your business credit score. Hi, Diane, how are you? But everything is going to start with your personal credit score. So whether you own a business and whether you have your DNB number and trying to build your business credit, everything is going to always start from your personal credit. So working on your personal credit, I believe it's the first step you have to take. For the business credit, that it's not reported automatically. So when you're building your business credit, that's something that you specifically have to do. You specifically have to either pay someone to do the reporting, or you have to make sure that you're following up on your reporting to make sure that payments are being posted, or you're being more careful on the type of cards and the type of business credit products that you sign up for to make sure that those products are going to actually report to your business credit. But regardless, your personal credit is is going to be the main driver. It's going to be every bank, every lender, funding, every credit card company is going to look at the first thing. Even if they take a look at your business credit, you're going to always look at your personal credit. So as I said, I have some tidbits to give you. Tidbits. Didn't like the way that sound. So I have some information to give you on how some of the things that you can do to start improving your score. Whether you have a low score, a middle score, or a good score, this will be enlightening for sure because it was really enlightening for me. Hi, Tamika, how are you? Thanks for joining. So the first thing is what makes up your credit score. And a good payment history, paying your bills on time, paying your credit card on time, only makes up 33% of your credit score. So if that's the only strategy in increasing your credit score, just know from today onwards that that only accounts for 33%. And you see, that's a pretty low percentage of what basically builds your credit score. So that's number one. Number two is having a higher percentage of unused credit gives you a much higher score than even making payment on time or your payment history. I'm not saying that you should go ahead and start paying late, but the percentage of your credit will increase more if you have a lower utilization ratio. And what that means that, for instance, if your available credit is say 25,000 and you only charge say 5,000, then that's a pretty low utilization rate. So your credit score will automatically be higher just because you have way more credit than what you're using. So, you know, and then, you know, I would think that, you know, you give credit to use it, right? You get credit to use it. So, you know, why using it's gonna hurt you. But the key is to always make sure that you're increasing your available credit every year. So whether it's once a year, you're gonna wanna call any major credit card company that you have to make sure that they're increasing your available credit. So if you have one credit card, let's say, and it has a $25,000 limit, every year you're gonna wanna make sure that credit card company is increasing your limit, because any other card that you get from that point on will have that one limit. So no one is gonna give you a card that's gonna be a lower limit than that original card that you have. So each card that you have will be at least a $25,000 credit limit on it. So you wanna make sure that one that you're calling, you know, your major credit card company, to make sure that they're increasing your available credit to, like, say, you know, if they increase it by 5,000 each year, then before you know it, you'll be at a pretty high balance pretty quickly. And also, of like, you know, those department store cards, you know, might as well you just like stop using them, because the points that you can, like, for instance, you know, you have, you know, Macy's and all these department store cards, and, you know, yes, they give these coupons, but if you check it out when you buy stuff from them online, you get the same deal as if when you use the card. So might as well you just stop using those cards if you use department store card for shopping and so forth, and just focus on using your major credit card, whether it's the American Express, you know, Capital One, MasterCard, whichever one that you use as a major credit card, to use that mainly so that, you know, you can get the points and also miles, or, you know, whatever incentive that you're getting from your credit card company. The next thing is, even if you have a pretty good credit, and for instance, you charges everything each month on your credit card, but at the time that you're charging everything, your credit card got maxed out. Like, for instance, if you charge everything all at once, and then after you, even if you pay it off at the end of that month, the timing in which your credit score is run. So for instance, if you're trying to get, you know, let's say a mortgage, or you're trying to get a line of credit, just because your credit balance is going to be so high at that point in time where they run your credit report, then that's going to reflect negatively on your credit. So you're going to also want to pay attention to the time in which people are going to be running your credit report, so that is not going to be at a point where your utilized, how much credit you're using, is pretty high, even though, you know, at the end of the month it's going to, you're going to pay it down, but for that month when you know that someone is going to run your credit, then you're going to want to make sure that you don't charge as much stuff on there, because you want to be able to get good interest rate, get, you know, get more funding and so forth. So you want to make sure that you're not putting yourself in a position that it may limit your chances of getting a really good rate or more money, just because at that point when they run your credit, your utilization was high and it went down at the end of the month. So you wanna also keep a check on that. How was everyone's weekend? Let me know if you have any questions. And the next thing that I found about your credit score, or credit score in general, is that the number of credit lines you have available. Based on my research, 3 to 5 is good. And make sure that these are mixed. So these are different types of credit. So whether it's a credit card, a line of credit, whether it's, you know, your mortgage, or different types of credit that you have, that will also help your credit score. So if it's if you have five credit cards, then the person with, you know, two credit cards, a mortgage, or, you know, a line of credit, you know, is going to have the higher score, even if, you know, you pay your bills on time and everything. So those are some of the little things that kind of make your credit score different a point, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 points that can basically affect, you know, how much money you get, what interest rate you get money, what interest rate you're able to borrow at, and so forth. So keep those little things in line. Also, having a zero balance on your credit card or your line of credit can actually lower your score. So not using it lower your score. Yikes. So you want to always make sure that you have a small balance outstanding, because that will keep on building your credit score instead of having none whatsoever. You know, this is a very highly credit dependent system. And, you know, understanding how it works, you know, is going to give you, you know, tremendous advantage. And now that you're in business and you're going to need more capital, more funding, more access to cash, then, you know, paying attention to this is going to be way more important than if, you know, you had a W-2 job and working and, you know, just doing the regular stuff that regular people do. Now you're in a different group, so you're doing different things. So, you know, having this information and paying attention to it should definitely set you apart and give you a higher score. So as I was saying, that the different types of credit that you have available to you, if you're a business owner, I would say make sure that you get a line of credit as soon as you're able to. It doesn't charge you any interest when you're not using it. Have a major credit card, and at least those two things should be able to get you moving forward. Always call and have your credit line increase each year. So never sit and settle for, like, you know, $10,000 or $25,000 credit card balance. Always call and have it increase every year, so that you can also, as your business grow, you can have access to more cash. And the next thing is check your credit score. There are a lot of free resources out there where you can go and check your credit score. I don't remember what the percentage is, but it's pretty high, probably around like 85% or 90% of people have an error on their credit score. And when, you know, there's an error, it can affect, you know, your, you know, interest rate and how much money you get without you even knowing. So always go ahead and check your credit score. If you have, you know, pretty high credit score, you want to get some credit protection, you know, one of those credit score company that basically will lock down your credit. So if anyone uses it, you get alerts and so forth. So you want to do that, you know, so that you can get those alerts so no one is using your credit. But go ahead and pull your credit report. There are a lot of free resources online for you to pull your credit report. Go through it and look to see if there's anything on there that you don't know what it is. You know, there's sometimes, you know, people are trying to collect from you, you don't even know it, like, you know, medical offices and so forth. Those are the ones that always come off guard, that, you know, you don't remember getting that $5 invoice, but they send it to a collection agency. So what I want you to do after you watch this is to go ahead and, if you haven't looked at your credit score in a long time, you want to go ahead and pull your credit report today, review it to see if there's anything on it that you basically don't know about and it's absolutely, you know, didn't happen to you and it's completely foreign, so that you can start looking at it. Because remember, that's pretty much 85% or more of Americans have an error on their credit report without them knowing. The next thing you're going to do is, if you find an error, if you're one of those persons that have an error, to go ahead and contact the credit bureau to make sure that you're able to get it resolved and get it removed. You may have to write a letter or something like that to them. And, you know, within a month or two, it will get removed from your credit score, and then you'll be back sailing and have that off your credit. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is, if you find anything that's in collection, whether it's like a medical bill or a large payment, is that, you know, if you go ahead and pay that off, it's gonna still remain on your credit, right? It's gonna show that you had some kind of collection against you at some point, so that's gonna still affect you. So what you're gonna wanna do is try to negotiate with them to see if you can pay a lesser amount. So for instance, if the collection is for $1,000, try to see if you can get out by paying, let's say, $500 or $700, because it's going to still report, and to see if during this negotiation, at least they can get it removed from your credit as well. So even if you have to pay the full balance, the least that can happen is for them to remove it from your credit, so that when you run it, you know, a month from now, you won't see that, you won't see any sort of collection against you. So you're gonna also wanna do that if you have any sort of active collection against you. So let me know if you have any questions about managing your credit score while you grow your business and how you can maximize the use of your credit score. As I mentioned that, you know, credit score becomes really important while you're trying to get access to more money in your business. It can help you to get favorable interest rates and also give you access to more cash. Yes, you can work on your business credit, but everything will start with your personal credit, and being able to manage that effectively will, you know, give you way more cash savings than anything else in your business. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to any questions that you may have. Just send me a message and I'll be happy to answer them. Have a good day.